Times are tough right now. Everything's getting more expensive, the job market sucks, but at the same time, people are using technology more than ever. Now, if you know networking and Wi-Fi, you can absolutely supplement your income by helping folks on the side or as a full-time gig. There's plenty of work out there if you look for it, and I know you can do it. But how do you even get started with something like that? In this video, I'm going to walk you through how I've landed new customers in the past when I was just starting out as an independent network consultant. How to get your foot in the door by offering free services that actually provide value to customers, and how to give those customers a proposed design that actually solves their problems and makes you extra profit by standardizing on the right equipment. All right, there's no better time to start than now, so let's get started. Before we dig too deep, I want to thank TP-Link for sponsoring this video. I'm going to show you later how standardizing on their Omada product line can increase your profit margins when selling gear to customers. But the real key is understanding how to approach and land customers in the first place. Without that, it doesn't matter what brand of equipment you choose. So let's start with the most important part, actually getting in front of customers. Now, I'm lucky enough to have built up a modest social media following, and that has now become my marketing. But before I was on YouTube, I tried everything from Google ads to Craigslist to newspaper ads. None of that stuff worked for me. Ultimately, you just need to find out what works best for you. And for me, nothing landed me more customers than literally walking into a business, introducing myself, handing them a card, and letting them know that I exist. Now, this is old school, but it does work. It might be awkward at first, but if you set yourself a goal of like, I'm going to give my business card to 5 people today, eventually the nerves go away. And if you're lucky, you'll end up striking up a conversation with a business owner about their networking, their wireless, or their internet need. Now, if that happens, here's the key. Listen to them, right? Don't just jump into a sales pitch. Listen to their pain points. Listen to what they find frustrating and make a mental note. Those are the issues that you're going to want to focus on when you get around to giving them a proposal. Also, make sure you're not leaving them empty-handed. You want to have a business card at least, or even better, create some sort of simple one-page flyer. That flyer is where you can offer some sort of free promotional service to get your foot in the door. Now, I've created a sample flyer here that you guys are free to download and copy for yourselves. Your promotional free service can be something like a quick security checkup or a network overview, as in, you know, let me take a look at what you've got today and I'm going to give you my expert opinion on best practices. But my favorite free service, hands down, is a wireless survey. It's quick, it's visual, and it makes you look like you know exactly what you're talking about. You can do wireless surveys with a laptop and something like NetSpot, which is $199 for the pro license, or you can get much more advanced with something like Hamina OnSite and the Osium Nomad. If they take you up on a free wireless survey, spend 30 minutes or so walking around their property, their office, store, restaurant, whatever, and then you can say, hey, I'm seeing a couple of wireless dead spots over here and over here. Or maybe you find out that they've got way too many access points. So regardless, now you've got some ammunition. You can put together an official estimate with best practice suggestions. You can reuse the client's existing hardware, if that makes sense, and then show them how you can improve their network and wireless so that they don't have to worry about it. One more tip here, I find it easier to focus on locally owned businesses. Chains like Walmart or Starbucks are gonna have their own centralized IT departments that you're never gonna get past. But, you know, like that barbecue place down on the corner or that dentist's office, you can usually get straight to the person who makes the decisions, and that's the person you need to be talking to.
And after you walk out the door, make sure you follow up with a short recap email within 24 hours. Something like, you know, hey, thanks for taking a few minutes to chat today. Here's a quick summary of what we talked about, and here's my contact info if you have any questions. The next time that business owner is having trouble with their internet or their Wi-Fi, you're going to be top of mind. Or they might actually want you to get them a proposal, and that is a great next step. You should send it as quickly as possible to show them how responsive they are. And it doesn't have to be super in-depth. You can keep it short with some bullet points. You're going to want to restate their top problems in their own words if possible, show them your recommended fixes, and then include a simple network diagram so that they can visualize it. I like using lucid.app for my diagrams, but there are also free programs you can can use, such as draw.io. And you don't want to overload them with any sort of technical detail. Also, don't give away too much info or else they might just go out and do it themselves. Your goal is to show them that you understand their needs, that you have a solution, and that you can make it happen without them having to worry about the tech. And that's where standardizing on a single hardware platform pays off, because you'll already know the gear in and out and you can put a proposal together quickly. And the equipment is going to now be consistent across all of your clients, which is ideal for keeping spares on hand. So let's now run through a real world example, and I'm going to show you exactly how the numbers work out when you use a system like TP-Link's Omada. The example here is a medium-sized restaurant. I used Hamina Planner to draw out all the walls, and then I added in some access points. I started with two of the EAP772 Wi-Fi 7 access points on the inside, and then one of the EAP772 outdoor access points on the patio. Between these three access points, this restaurant is going to be fully covered with Wi-Fi 7. So here we can see one access point, a two access point, three access point, and if we turn on our visualizer, here we can see our 6 GHz coverage is absolutely bathing the whole place in Wi-Fi, same with 5 GHz, and same with 2.4 GHz. I also factored in cable runs for half a dozen POS terminals, as well as 6 to 8 surveillance cameras, all terminating to this little office right off the kitchen. For the router, we're going to go with the ER707M2, which has dual 2.5 gigabit ports. One is a WAN port, and the other one can be configured as WAN or LAN. It also has 5 gigabit ports that can be configured as WAN or LAN as well. Now, this gives them dual WAN capability for internet redundancy, plus all of the security that you want on the LAN side. And typically what I would do in this situation is I would have one secure LAN for the network equipment, the office computers, the printers. I'd have a separate VLAN for the point of sale system, and then a guest network for the customers. For the cameras, I would either put them in their own secure VLAN, or I would just include them in the default secure LAN. From there, we can connect to a 24-port PoE switch. In this case, we're going to use the SG3428 XPPM2. That's going to give us 24 2.5 gigabit PoE ports and a 500 watt PoE budget. Plenty of power for all the cameras, the access points, and also the point of sale system if those happen to be PoE enabled. For management of the network, we can toss in the OC220 hardware controller. This is going to be TP-Link's latest model controller, or we can use Omada's cloud controller. So why does this work for the customer, right? You've got PoE for all of your access points and your cameras, which is going to keep everything a lot cleaner. You've got the security that you need to keep the point of sale system separate from the other VLANs, as well as the guest wireless. And you got plenty of room to grow if you simply just toss in another network switch. Let's now look at the numbers. At MSRP, this setup comes to about $1,520 in hardware. If you're at Omada's Elite tier, your cost is going to be $1,216, or 20% off. Not counting whatever you charge for your labor, the design, or any sort of ongoing management, you've already pocketed over $300 in profit margin just by using Omada. I should also mention that while I use the EAP772 outdoor for this deployment, that's probably a little bit of overkill for the size of the patio. TP-Link's got the EAP725 outdoor coming in November, which is going to be a little bit more cost effective. And speaking of cost effective, what if your customer doesn't have this kind of budget for the network? Well, you've got options, right? Let's look at a more budget-friendly design. Using that same restaurant example, but instead we're going to go with a Wi-Fi 6 setup with gigabit Ethernet. That's still going to be plenty powerful for most restaurant deployments. So in this case, we're going to go with the ER605 gateway and the SG2428 LP switch. That's going to give us 16 PoE ports, which again should be plenty for this install. And then for the access points, we're going to use the EAP653s on the inside and the EAP610 outdoor on the patio. Instead of the hardware controller, we're going to use the Omada Cloud, and that's going to bring the total customer cost for our budget-friendly network to just about $640, of which we're still making over $125 in hardware margin at the elite partner level. And this same setup can be cookie cutter replicated over and over to different customers. The key here is standardization. If you do a few installs like this every month, those hardware margins are going to stack up. Plus, you're not reinventing the wheel every install. You know the gear, you know the setup process, and you can support everything a lot quicker. Omada tends to be more affordable than some of the bigger names out there, especially those devices that have ongoing license fees. And that's going to make a huge difference when you're putting together a proposal for your customer. You've got tons of choices for any size budget, and you get a full stack of hardware. You've got routers, switches, and Wi-Fi all combined into a single interface, which means effective administration for your customers. So then how can you get these hardware margins? The first thing you have to do is sign up for the TP-Link Omada Partner Program. I'll have links down in the description of the video. You start with 10% off MSRP when you purchase through their authorized distributors. Then, once you're an Omada partner, you can go up in discount tiers based on the volume of sales that you do quarterly, all the way up to Elite tier, which adds 10% on top of the typical 10% that you would get from an authorized distributor. That's how you get the 20% total margin on hardware, like I was showing in my restaurant example. Omada partners can also do deal registration, which means if you're bidding on a larger project, you can get custom pricing that goes beyond the standard margins, keeping you competitive while still making that hardware profit. And if you want to learn Omada or start building with Omada in your lab environment, TP-Link is offering 50% off their Wi-Fi 7 demo kit, which includes the ER707M2 gateway that I used for that restaurant example. You get a pair of Wi-Fi 7 EAP723 access points, a 10-port PoE gigabit switch, and the OC220 hardware controller. The Wi-Fi 7 demo kit is just under $250, and it's an excellent way to start learning the platform. At the end of the day, if you're not making margins on the hardware, you're leaving money on the table. The labor is great, but the hardware is often where the easiest extra profit lives. Standardizing on a single vendor doesn't just help with pricing, it also makes your life easier. You get faster at the setup and the troubleshooting, you only have to learn one ecosystem, and you can even keep a few spare parts on hand if something fails at a client site so that you can swap it out immediately and then be their hero. And here's one more often overlooked aspect of a hardware partner. Support, right? When issues do pop up, having access to decent warranties and actual people that you can call for support makes your life a lot easier. Omada has dedicated account managers, tech support, and marketing assistants to help you keep your customers happy. And of course, if you're not looking to do this for a living, but you do need to have this kind of work done, you can always contact us here at Crosstalk Solutions. We've got a team of friendly network experts standing by who can design the network, recommend hardware, and make sure that everything is built the right way from day one. Okay, if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my complete Omada setup guide, which is perfect for getting you started on this journey. And the bottom video is my recent comparison of Starlink versus 5G for backup internet.